tres.
Sorry for my little. There we are. First piece, when this piece finished, the audience was happy, I think, or I was. It was something great. Now I'm going to show other videos. The next one is that I want to you to hear is the Samaritan Woman. So these are all episodes from the Gospel of St. John. This piece describes the meeting that happened between Jesus and a woman from Samaria. Jesus meets this woman at the well. He asks her for water, and the woman is surprised that the Jew would talk to her because, as you know, Samaria was the capital of the northern kingdom of Israel, and it was very filled with pagans, pagan culture. So the Jews from Judea wouldn't talk to them. As they talk, long story short, she discovers that Jesus knows her. He knows that she had five husbands. And he knows the interior thirst that she has, because none of the five husbands she had was able to quench that thirst for happiness. And Jesus falls in love with this fact, with her need, and tells her that he is the living water that she's been looking for, she has been looking for. So one interesting thing that I think about this passage is that Jesus wasn't just speaking with her, but he was enjoying the conversation with her. So much that the Gospel says that he stayed with the people in Samaria her town for 2 days. So it would be like, I enjoyed so much being with you that I changed my ticket for 2 days later, something like that. So he changed his plans to be with them. I can't imagine what kind of attractiveness they had for him and he had for them. The persistent melodic lines that you will hear and the dense harmony express this intense thirst that she has, but also that Jesus has, to offer this water to her, to save her. Towards the climax of the piece that is the moment that is more intense, the piece, you will hear the Samaritans telling the woman that they now believe in Jesus, not just because of what she saw, but because of what they saw and heard. And there are no miracles in this story, in the sense, nothing, no healing, nothing extraordinary. So I leave you to imagine what they might have seen that day that moved them to this certainty and this desire of hosting Jesus in town. This piece so is full of that density of desire from both sides. The Samaritan woman who desires Jesus and Jesus who desires the Samaritan woman. So it was here before.
Thank you.
So did you like it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. The next one is The Man Born Blind, one that I want to show today. And this is a story of a man who was born blind. And there is a long succession of crazy events happening here that follow the miracle. The Pharisees cannot accept that the true Messiah would heal on a Sabbath, that is the day of repose for the Jews. But the fact is that they have in front of them a man who was blind and now can see. So first they start trying to deny that he was blind. Then they call the parents to try to see if he was not blind. Sorry. Here. But of course the parents cannot deny the facts. And so they go on. Then they say that he's a sinner because he has healed on a Sabbath. But the former blind man asks, but how can he be a sinner if he heals on a, if he performs such a sign? So eventually the Pharisees throw the guy away, and Jesus accuses them of being blind. He's very smart. Jesus always learns from the circumstance, you know, talks about the eternal water, now he talks about blindness, and he tells that to them. The one thing that I would like to say is that I realized how challenging this piece is when I went to the rehearsal with the vocal lessons. It's a very challenging piece because of all the ongoing changes in the time signature, the rhythm, the intonation, different layers of discourse going on, and then there's a certain aggression mixed with confusion that the choir needs to portray. So it's very difficult to sing and also not easy to conduct. So, and then you will see these obstinate rhythmic patterns many times that show the obstinacy, the stubbornness of the Pharisees. So all these elements are present in this music.
This man is not from God because he does not keep the Sabbath. This man is not from God because he does not keep the Sabbath. This man is not from God because he does not keep the Sabbath. This man is not from God because he does not keep the Sabbath.
I'm gonna say you're a master, a song.
is not from God, because he does not keep the Sabbath. This man is not from God, because he does not keep the Sabbath.
So a next piece that I would like to for you to hear, and then whatever time we have, I have more videos, but I don't want to keep you here all night, is this woman is a woman caught in adultery. It's one of the most beautiful moments of the gospel. And it's an interesting, I tell you briefly the episode. So some Jews bring to Jesus a woman caught in adultery to see whether he would fulfill the law, what means that they need to stone her to death, as still happens nowadays in many places, or instead ask for a pardon for her, what means that he would show love but would not be fulfilling the law. It's interesting because many times I see that they test in the same way Pope Francis. Now, what are you going to do? So 2,000 years later we have the same situations that Jesus needs to face. And so they try to see if he's going to privilege law or mercy. And one interesting fact is that actually the same Jews there in the Gospel perceive that both the Mosaic law and, to use a modern term, the relativism, were insufficient. They were trying to see where Jesus would fall, but both of them would be insufficient. And they knew that. They knew that they weren't satisfied by any of those. Otherwise, why would they try to test Jesus to that, no? And the lyrics reproduce the full text of the chapter, so it will be easy, I don't need to say more about that. One thing that you might want to know, trivia, is that this is the only piece in my life, I think, that I wrote for an entire day, and at the end of the day I destroyed it and I started over. And the reason was because first I started like trying to be harsh, and I said, but that is not, doesn't reproduce Jesus' feelings. So day and day something else, but it was very sentimental, melody, kind of sentimental thing. And I realized that that doesn't express the real experience of being forgiven. It's not a sentimental thing, it's something that you are being revealed again. And so I understood that I need to start from my experience of being forgiven. That is usually something that is an experience of humbleness, of sobriety, and of joy at the same time. So it's an experience in which you are full of another, not of yourself. One characteristic that I invite you to follow in this piece is that there is only one melody for 4 minutes. It's a 4-minute melody, like a circular melody. And I mean, I don't know how in the hell it came out like that, but it was, I don't think I would be able to do it again. So it's a 1 4-minute melody, and the harmonic progression is very simple. It's 5-6 chords, because I wanted to keep that same simplicity. And I hope they stop there to ring their horn downstairs. Okay, so you just see 5 or 6 chords, but you will like it. So everyone likes it, so I'm safe with this one.
Thank you.
Videos. I don't know, director of Crossroads, how much time I have.
Another one.
Another one?
Yes.
So you can choose between Judas. This is like a market. I feel like Van Gogh, who could sell paintings only to his brother in life. You know, maybe next century this is famous. Who knows? So I can have Judas. I have video of Judas, Nicodemus, or Resurrection. What is the longest one? Should we take a vote? You say
Nicodemus, right?
Huh?
Judas, of course.
No, Judas is
Judas?
Twist, Nicodemus. Judas
Nicodemus. You don't know. What do you want?
I don't know. Well, maybe we can do Judas is short. We can do Judas and then Nicodemus, and then that's okay.
Yes,
so we
yes,
satisfy
yes.
both people. Also, because ending with Judas is like, ah. So, anyway, Judas, you all know what this is about. What happened that night is one of the most famous characters in the Gospel, I think. And this moment, what describes is he's disappointed at Jesus. Okay, he was close to Jesus. He was one of the preferred of Jesus. He was 3 years with him. I mean, we would pay $1 billion to be there, no? And he was disappointed that he was so unable to save the world as Judas was expecting. What is the same drama that most Christians have nowadays? Why is this so slow? This piece takes the... And so anyway, the interesting thing is that at a certain moment, Jesus let it all sink, let it all go, and instead of using his amazing power to respond to the anguishes of man, to solve the problem, he apparently disappointed man, and he followed this apparently slow pace of love. And the piece that we are about to listen then talks about the instant in which Jesus at the Last Supper tells Judas to do this quickly, what he already had decided to do. And it has all a sense of dizziness. The piece is kind of a dizzy moment in which this diabolic turn in Judas takes place. So there is lots of dissonance that expresses this confusion. The format of this piece is a passacaglia. So here you have food for thought. Passacaglia is like an ostinato, usually in the bass, here is a little all over, that keeps going. So ostinato means a repeated pattern, and then on top of it there are variations, okay? The rhythm is based on an Argentinean folkloric dance, if you're interested in knowing that too. And the phrases that we hear are very short phrases, right? Because Satan is the devil is the one that divides. No, it's not the corruption, it's something that gets divided. And so even the phrases in this song, it's a very short song, it's all, they're all like, corrupted, they are all taken apart, let's say. So they're always short phrases. They don't have a beautiful, complete form. Yeah, I hope in this short piece you can be brought somehow into the moment of that disaster, of that night, the distress of that nocturnal betrayal.
And to the home of some say, it didn't enter in. And to the home of some say, it didn't enter in. And to the home of some say,
he left at once, he was gone.